When it comes to wedding gifts, most people would be happy with a set of crockery, maybe a donation towards the honeymoon, or perhaps just a toaster. So how would you feel if you got a castle? Find out who received this lavish gift and exactly where I am in just a moment. Today's house hunters are trading in their London home for the space that comes with country life, both outside and in. I don't know if you have that sort of facility back home.
Oh, look, his and hers sink. And plenty of cupboard space for all my clothes, so...
no comments?
Yes, quite.
And one half of our couple can't quite take in everything that's on offer.
I'm actually blown away.
Today I'm in North Yorkshire, and this is the magnificent Ripley Castle close to the Yorkshire Dales. It's home to the Inglebys and has been in the very same family name since 1309, when Sir Thomas Ingleby married heiress Edwina Thwenge and received this castle as a dowry. Now, for over 700 years, the family have endured civil wars, religious unrest, recessions and even plague, and have still managed to keep hold of this historical landmark. A truly magnificent wedding present that really has stood the test of time. North Yorkshire, covering an area of over 3,300 square miles, virtually spans coast to coast across the neck of England. A staggering 40% of the county is made up of beautiful national parks, and to the south lies the market town of Skipton. Its castle, built in 1090, is unmissable with six impressive drum towers. It was the only royalist stronghold in the north of England, finally surrendering to Cromwell in 1645. Lying in the wooded Dale of Rye are the haunting remains of Revo Abbey. With its towering arches and pillars, it was the 12th century powerhouse for the Cistercian order of monks. Their desire was to follow a strict life of prayer with little contact from the outside world, so the abbey's remote location was well suited. To the east lies the North Yorkshire Moors Railway. Planned by the renowned engineer George Stephenson in 1836, today this steam heritage line carries over 350,000 passengers a year on its 18 miles of track. So with North Yorkshire's national heritage, staggering open countryside and historic towns, it's probably not surprising that it's full steam ahead when it comes to attracting would-be escapees. The average price of a detached house here in North Yorkshire comes in at just under £280,000, which is around £20,000 below the national figure. But it's not just the attractive prices and housing stock that's pulling people to this area. Well-regarded local schools and great rail links means that people are flocking here from as far afield as London. And it's from the capital that today's buyers are looking to escape. Company accounts manager Chris and his events coordinator wife Kat currently live in the London suburb of North Finchley with their two sons, 7-year-old Sam and Oliver, who's six.
We've been in Finchley for 8 years and together we've been in London for close to 19 years. We're getting to that stage now where we want to move out into the country just to have that next stage for the boys to enjoy the outdoors, and London doesn't really give us that.
Our couple's five-bed terraced Finchley home is located within a great community and close to amenities. But as Chris and Kat both have country roots, they now feel they need more room and a more rural outlook for their growing family.
We've chosen to move to Yorkshire because it's closer to my family. We wanted to move out of London and try and find a much bigger place to enjoy the countryside, and we figured actually moving north would be the obvious choice for financial reasons and close to the bigger cities where we can both work.
Mm. I grew up in a really rural village. Well, it wasn't even a village, it was more of a hamlet. And so that way of life really appeals to me. And North Yorkshire is just stunning.
Creating more family time is a major driver for this move, and relocating to North Yorkshire will give them all a chance to expand on their hobbies.
We're a pretty active family, and at the weekends, as well as getting out on our bike and going for walks, we also enjoy playing tennis. The boys like playing football. When I grew up in the countryside, I loved horse riding, and so that's something I'd really dearly like to pick up again when moving to North Yorkshire, is to get back into riding.
So, all in all, this escape seems to be shaping up to be a really positive move for everyone. And I mean everyone.
Friends up north are looking forward to having us back, and the friends in London are just happy that we're making this this move, and they're really looking forward to coming to see us.
Chris and Kat would like to focus their search within the golden triangle of Harrogate, York and Leeds, and are happy to cross the border into West Yorkshire. I'm catching up with them to find out a little bit more about what they're looking for from their ideal country property. Welcome both of you to North Yorkshire. Now, this is a big, bold move, isn't it? I mean, you're living in a very comfortable part of North London where people seem to have the best of both worlds.
Mm. Yes, it's a big upheaval. Really exciting, but I must admit, it was been really difficult telling people, and the boys are initially kind of a bit nervous and apprehensive, but also really excited.
This is the Golden Triangle we're talking about, aren't we? You know, Harrogate, Leeds and York. Very popular part of the world.
Yes.
For all the reasons you probably love it as well, doesn't it? Yeah. It's beautiful, you've got access to the Dales as well. But this work thing, how long are you prepared to be in the car going to and from work?
I'd say maximum an hour. I'm doing an hour in London at the minute. So, you know, that an hour would be fine, but any shorter would be fantastic.
OK, let's go through your shopping list then.
So, four bedrooms, lovely big kitchen for entertaining. Possibly in an outbuilding, maybe something that, you know, it'd be great to be able to have friends to stay, and if there was somewhere with a bit of outside space that had an outbuilding where there was an annex.
We'd like something with a bit of history behind it.
Right. You know,
something not too modern.
What kind of environment are you looking for?
So it would be nice to be in a community, a village community or just out of town, but somewhere that's got a nice pub, a village hall, a school, you know, something there where there's, you know, things going on that we can get involved in.
Everybody wants to be on the edge of a village, but they want a bit of land, the 1 acre to 2 acres. Yeah. Is that a deal breaker?
No, I mean, if it was around countryside that wasn't owned by us, and that's lovely, you know, we're looking out to fields and that's wonderful. Yeah.
What budget have you given yourself to achieve this?
We've got a budget of £800,000, max £850,000.
OK, well, look, we've got some cracking properties lined up. Let's see if we can find the right one for you. Come in, mate.
Exciting, thank you.
With a maximum budget of £850,000, Chris and Kat want a detached character home, a large kitchen diner, four bedrooms, land without buildings and that all-important village location. We've found some fantastic properties to tempt them with, and at each one, I'll be asking them to guess the price before I reveal it. And one will be our mystery house, which may have our couple praying for divine intervention to help them make the right choice. Of course, this big move up here, it's about the kids and giving them a better quality of life, a different way of life, if you like. Have you tried to bribe your boys with potential pets or anything like that?
You said it.
Have you really?
It didn't take much bribery, though.
No, they were talking about it anyway, so we realised that was a good carrot to dangle.
Yeah. Definitely.
So, puppies on the cards, I think.
Oh, wow.
Our first property is located just over the West Yorkshire border in the village of Walton, just 3 miles from the market town of Wetherby. With its narrow streets, many flanked with honey-coloured Yorkstone buildings, Wetherby can trace its roots back to 1086. It has a great range of shops, including a post office, coffee bars, restaurants, pubs and numerous general stores. The town even has World War II connections with Hollywood glamour. A silver screen heartthrob Clark Gable was stationed at nearby RAF Marston Moor. Let's hope we can bring a little bit of Tinseltown excitement with our first house back in Walton.
Now come right in, because I'm hoping you'll get a really nice view of this substantial pile of stone.
Yeah, it's fantastic. Lovely garden as well. Stunning from the outside, lovely.
You've got local pub.
Yes.
You've got a local cricket club.
Ooh, tick.
Good for the boys.
Yes.
Now, you've got an Ofsted-rated good school within about a mile, but you've got Wetherby just a couple of miles up the road.
Fantastic.
Let's go inside.
Built in 1870, this beautiful detached stone farmhouse was fully refurbished a few years back to provide up-to-date 21st century living. Yet it retains many 19th century character features. We're heading straight to the expansive living room.
Oh, it's lovely. Really light, lovely big windows.
Yeah, nice high ceilings.
Well, you really pointed out those windows from outside.
Yeah. Well, sometimes in like houses that have got lots of character, you get the smaller windows and it seems a bit dark inside, but you can't say the same for this property. It's lovely.
Back home, are you kitchen dwellers?
It's
are you living
probably room? Kitchen, yeah.
Yeah, we're kitchen.
Somewhere where we can all meet.
Let's keep looking around.
Okay.
The heart of the home, as in most people's houses, is the kitchen.
Oh, lovely. Nice big kitchen, and, you know, sociable as well. So when you're cooking and preparing the food, you can chat to people, glass of wine. Yeah, that's good.
Now, for when you do your hyacinth bouquet bits, you've got a formal dining room at the top end of the house and a snug, but it will be a decent-sized living room in most other people's houses. Yeah. Just behind me here, you've got a utility room.
Excellent.
Really good-sized utility room, which means you get all the white goods that you don't normally use out of the kitchen.
That would be a real benefit. Yeah.
Upstairs next, let me squeeze through. Thank you very much.
From the kitchen, we make our way to the main hallway, where the staircase leads up to the first floor. Doors from a spacious landing open to reveal four bright and airy bedrooms, one of which has an ensuite shower. There's also a very large modern family bathroom with separate shower area. And we're making our way into the largest of the bedrooms.
This is your master.
Right.
OK.
Lovely size.
Yeah.
Lovely really features as well, with a fireplace. Really pretty.
As you've got a walk-through wardrobe with an ensuite. I'm going to take a quick peek.
Right, OK.
I don't know if you have that sort of facility back home.
No. Look, his and her sink. And plenty of cupboard space for all my clothes, so...
no comments?
Yes, quite. So, four bedrooms.
Yeah.
The other with an ensuite, which, you know, you want your guests to be comfortable, not having to use the family bathroom. Yeah. So you've got three bathrooms in total on on this floor.
Wow, really?
It's big, isn't it?
Yeah, it's big, yeah.
Well, you both sound very positive to this. But I want to show you something that you'll get in this house that you just can't get in London. Follow me.
Okay. Now I'm intrigued.
Back out onto the hallway and up a second staircase, we find a surprising bonus space hidden away at the top of the house.
Now, of course, you probably could get this in London if you were a Premiership footballer.
Oh, wow! This is amazing. Yeah, I'm genuinely blown away.
No, it's lad space, isn't it? Come on.
Yeah. OK, lad space. Yeah, it's fantastic. And actually, our eldest plays a guitar, and the youngest would definitely want to play the drums because he's that sort of personality.
So, you like what you see?
Yeah, definitely.
Let's walk through the house out to the garden and then start thinking about price, OK?
Oh, gosh.
I'm getting the feeling Kat and Chris can really see the positives that come with this house, and I'm confident they'll be impressed with what's on offer outside.
So quite a private area here for your barbecues, but something a bit different here.
Wow.
This field is leased.
Okay.
It was initially a 15-year lease. There's 5 years unexpired. So if you buy this house, you have this field for 5 more years.
Yeah.
Okay.
And in that time, you've got enough time to negotiate or maybe even see if you can buy it.
It's a really nice surprise, unexpected.
Now then, difficult thing is pricing it.
Okay. I shall go in with around £800,000.
Okay.
Yeah. I was thinking just below, but not far off.
This house is on the market £850,000.
Okay.
And that's come down just shy of, well, just under £900,000.
Okay.
So they've given it a substantial price reduction.
Okay.
But you've got a lot of property here. Your job now is to go back into the house and have a good think about it. And I'll meet you outside whenever you're done. All right?
Justin,
great.
Thank you very much.
At £850,000, this beautifully renovated 19th century farmhouse is at the top of Kat and Chris's budget. But it does give them a fantastic living space, which includes a great kitchen diner, four double bedrooms, lots of land, and that all-important village location.
The house is fantastic. I really like it. From the outside, lovely garden, lovely, lovely grounds. When you came inside, all the rooms are really good sizes, and actually, you could move straight in. There's nothing that you need to do to the property.
I think this house is lovely. It's got a lot of potential. There's certainly a few surprises in there. The attic, certainly, we didn't see that one come in. And this paddock certainly gives us something to think about.
So, your first viewing.
Yes. Yep.
How's it feel? Is the dream getting closer?
It's a great start. Yeah, really positive. Start. Yeah.
Oh, hopefully something to compare the other two with. Yeah. Come with me.
Yorkshire's open moorland and dales have long been associated with farming. But how many of us would have guessed a little bit of Spain has landed right here in the heart of the Yorkshire countryside? With Kat and Chris longing for a rural escape, we thought we'd send them to meet farmer and butcher Chris Wildman to find out more about this continental invader.
So what kind of food products do you make here?
So we make a traditional butchery, so pork, beef, lamb, but then we've kind of diversified those products into doing more cured products, so Italian salami, and also obviously the Spanish Yorkshire chorizo. And that was kind of a, because we had to, normal fresh meat just wasn't really selling as well as I'd hoped. So I diversified into doing more cured products, which has got a longer shelf life, and also they were getting quite trendy and people really liked the idea. We can just go down to the butchery and have a look. It's just down here, shall we go?
Brilliant. Great.
The traditional Spanish chorizo can be eaten cooked, or as many like it, after a few weeks curing. To get an idea of how this sausage delicacy is made, Kat and Chris are getting a crash course in Chris's chorizo preparation area. The ingredients consist of minced pork, salt, paprika, pepper, and a top-secret spicy addition. With this already prepared, they're ready to begin making the chorizo sausage.
So we'll get some pepper in there, some salt, straight in here, and then we'll do some mixing. And we'll just literally mix it in.
So how long do you need to leave it to cure it before we can actually try it?
3 to 5 weeks is the standard time, really, for the full curing process. We're looking to lose about 30% in weight, and then that means it's going to be a fully cured chorizo.
Chris makes around 100 sausages a week using this tried and tested recipe. Once thoroughly mixed, we're ready for the next stage.
Right, so this is where the sausages are made.
It is. So we're literally going to put the meat into this nice old filler. Just need to make sure we get the air out of here. So all we're going to do is push the meat into the skins. Yeah. And then you just control the speed with your left hand. So we're not overfilling, but we're not underfilling. That's it. Do you want to have a go?
Go on then. Well, you go, Chris.
There you go. So just gently on there, and then wind away.
You'd have quite a long great. Reach.
Great.
Yeah, super.
I'll have a go as well, yeah, definitely. So it's not as easy as it looks. You've got to have quite a lot of control over the handle. Ooh.
That's great, and stop.
Oh, gosh.
The secret to a good chorizo is in the curing. It's vital the filled skins are hung in a humidity and temperature-controlled environment, allowing the meat to dry out slowly. And once it's ready, our couple can sample this full-of-flavour sausage.
Here we go, here we've got
fantastic.
The samples to try.
Yeah, what we've been looking forward to. So what we've got here, we've got your Yorkshire
chorizo. Yeah, so this is the original Yorkshire chorizo. So
can we
have a little piece of that one first.
Actually, no, you can really get the picante.
Yeah, you get it a few seconds after. Mm. What would you recommend eating this with?
It's great with white fish, scallops, on some pasta. Kids love it, usually.
Let's hope we can conjure up our own appealing delight as we head back to our property search. Our second house is located in the North Yorkshire village of Branton Green, around 4 miles south of the small town of Boroughbridge. This quaint market town offers everything Kat and Chris could want from their new life in the country. A butcher supplying locally farmed meat, great cafes and bars, all wrapped up in an attractive high street. Back in Branton Green, there's a post office and stores, as well as a church. And hopefully, the house we've come to see will live up to our buyer's expectations.
In a lot of ways, what you've asked for is a stereotypical escape to the country home. So we found you one.
Yes.
We're steering around the front door. She's gorgeous, isn't she?
Absolutely stunning.
Yeah, beautiful.
I love the wisteria.
Well, this village is called Branton Green, but it almost forms part of Great Usburn. Right. They're right next door to each other. Mm-hmm. And so just a walk from your front door, mm-hmm. you've got the local post office and shop.
It all looked a short walk away. We drove past a cricket pitch as well and an amazing sports centre.
The cricket club has a really good junior section to it as well. Oh, right. Pretty much the first thing the owner of this house said to me is, oh, they've got boys that like the cricket here.
Oh, fantastic.
Now then, the property itself. Built in the late 1800s.
Wow, it is really pretty. Beautiful. It looks pretty big as well. Yeah, I'm interested to know how many bedrooms it's got.
I'm always running out of fingers. Let me show
really?
You.
Come on. Oh, wow.
This Grade II listed double-fronted Victorian property is split over three floors. On the ground floor, there's no shortage of space with three separate reception rooms and a large farmhouse kitchen. We're starting off our tour in the living room at the front of the house.
Now, there's a few living rooms to draw upon.
Oh, this is really cosy. Love that fireplace.
It's amazing.
Well, these are normally on the tick list of people that are moving out of the big city, aren't they?
Yeah.
I think anybody that moves here will probably have to put their own touch on this place. Yeah. You know, try and maybe think about lighting the rooms in a perhaps more modern way. But you've got this room, which is bigger than the other reception room on the other side of the main entrance hall.
Yeah. You can imagine nice, warm, winter's evenings in here with this fire on. It's lovely, really nice and cosy.
Really nice.
Let's go to the kitchen.
Okay, follow you.
You're downstairs, Lou, just through there.
Right.
The kitchen is the modern part of the property.
Oh, well, yeah.
Yeah, totally different.
Yeah, isn't it?
Yeah.
But it works.
No, it completely works, and it's really homely as well.
I wasn't expecting it.
So. And a great, you know, space to have off the kitchen, cosy for the family.
Really bright, and the window is literally the full length of the property.
Yeah.
And they just look out onto your land and gardens. And there's also a small room through there. That's like the third separate reception room.
Okay.
So all their stuff is out of the way.
No, it's fantastic. Really light. I'm looking forward to seeing outside as well.
And split over the first and second floors. They're overflowing with warmth and character and have a real cosy feel. There's also two modern family bathrooms. And next, we're heading for the biggest of the six bedrooms.
I think we're all at head height.
Yeah, definitely, we're fine.
But, back to character.
Yeah. Oh, this is fantastic. A lovely room and an ensuite.
Yeah. Mm.
Really big windows as well, so plenty of light.
I know you're very positive walking around in the first house, but you look more comfortable in this one.
I feel really positive about it.
This has a character that we're after, certainly, doesn't it?
It reminds me, some of the features remind me of sort of growing up in the family homes around, definitely.
You'll have loads of rooms to look around, including the lovely space above us. I'm dying to show you what's outside, so come
with me. OK, I can't wait.
The property stands in a one-acre plot with an additional rented 3.5-acre paddock attached. To the rear, there's a large lawned area complete with a shepherd's hut, which is bound to appeal to their two sons. And for Chris and Kat, this place has more outbuildings than you could shake a stick at. Stables, a workshop, a carport, and this, a fantastic stone barn which is overflowing with possibilities.
So you'll be pleased to hear that this building is contained within the property.
Right.
Okay. It actually predates the house we've been looking at.
Yes, you can tell by.
You've got plenty of space for residential accommodation. It's got electricity supplied to it. It's got chickens inside it. You can hear it at the moment. But it's also got water as well.
Okay.
I mean, it's primed and ready. This is an amazing project, but it's something you never have to do if you don't want to.
No.
There's a wonderful workshop in there. There's a tack store because you want the tack for the horses you keep in your one-acre paddock.
Oh, my word.
Wow.
For a first-time equestrian property, if you like, I mean, this is it.
I'm absolutely blown away.
It's ticking a lot of the wish list, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, definitely. Yeah. I'm actually blown away.
Look at you.
I know.
You see, these are the emotions and the reactions I was hoping I'd get. Just as long as you're not allergic to chickens.
Can't speak. Yeah, no, it's absolutely lovely. It really reminds me of lots of things. I'm completely blown away. It's really
sweet. It's got everything.
How much would you pay for it?
I think it's going to be more than £8.50. Go on, I'm going to go for £8.75.
All right.
What do you think?
I'm going to go for over £900, £915.
Good guessing.
Really? My eyes are still watering.
I'm afraid it is over budget.
Yeah.
On the market at £875,000.
Oh, wow. OK. Spot on, but...
Spot on. And we've spoken to the owner, and because they know your position, they said they would entertain offers of around £850,000.
Okay. Oh, my goodness.
So you could get this on budget.
I'm incredible.
That would be unbelievable. I'm completely... Well, I'm speechless. It's amazing.
There's so much for the property, isn't there?
There's so much you haven't seen yet.
Yeah, yeah.
And I feel like that, yeah, there is.
So have a refresh. Go back and have a look at everything on your own. I'll catch up with you in a moment.
Thank you.
Well, fantastic reactions to, well, quite clearly a fantastic property. It gives them everything they wanted in the location with the village, in the beautiful property, but also people like to have something else, something they haven't thought of. And this property here gives them just that, something for maybe Chris to get involved in the future. I'm really pleased in how this has gone. At £875,000, but with room to negotiate, this Grade II listed character house seems a perfect fit for our couple. It features a large kitchen diner, 6 bedrooms, masses of outside space, a partly converted barn, stables, and it's all in a great edge of village location.
Wow.
Wow!
Oh my goodness. Oh my word. I think I've fallen in love with this house. Absolutely love it. We've got a ready-made play area. I can't believe it.
Table tennis table in here. No?
Yeah, you could.
My head and heart are both aligned, I would say. This looks like an amazing investment in the property. It ticks a lot of the wish list that we set out at the beginning, and it really has everything we've asked for.
I can't believe the space, and this is the driveway. So you drive in here. Yes, a few tears. I think it was just bringing back a lot of memories, a lot of nostalgia, things from my childhood that actually I'm looking to recreate with my family and my children.
You have to get used to that door, won't you?
I know. That's a substantial door.
So, substantial house and property.
Yeah.
You like this, didn't you?
Yeah.
I really like it.
Well, that's all we're going to look at today. Hopefully something really good to think on tonight.
Definitely.
Absolutely. Should we go?
Yep.
Chris and Kat, along with their 2 young sons, are looking to leave the busy North London suburb of Finchley to set up home in North Yorkshire with a budget of £850,000. Still to come, we've got the Mystery House, which could be blessing our 2 buyers with their perfect escape to the country.
Right?
Oh, my word. I was going to say holy moly, but yeah.
And I'll be getting a bit of extra support to help me on all my house hunting travels.
Look at that, the detail on it is amazing. Well, I'm pleased to report there seems to be a bit of a buzz around the Escape to the Country camp this morning because I think we all feel we've got 2 great properties already in the bag. And with that in mind, and because we're going to see the Mystery House, we're prepared to take a bit of a gamble. Now, Kat has already alluded to the fact that she's prepared to compromise on that outside space. And if she's prepared to sacrifice that land, well, all my prayers could well be answered.
Our Mystery House is in the village of Clifford, back across the county border into West Yorkshire. And only a mile and a half to the north are the varied amenities of Boston Spa. As its name suggests, this spa town gained its spurs in 1744 when John Shires discovered sulphur springs in the surrounding magnesium limestone hills. But within decades, the town's nurturing waters had lost out to nearby Harrogate. Today, Boston Spa's retail therapy is more appealing, boasting 2 public houses, a host of eateries, a general store and post office. And back in Clifford, this small village is not without its attractions either.
Now, this village, 2 churches, outnumbered by 3 pubs. That's all right,
good.
Isn't it?
Good start.
Perfect odds.
That's two you can get banned from and still have friends in the village. I don't know why I'm looking at you. Do you like it here?
It's very pretty. Lovely. Yeah, really nice. Very pretty.
But there was at least one other place of worship in the village, which has now been converted into our mystery house.
In we come. Something a little bit different.
Very different.
What is it, a church? It's a...
What would you say if I was to say it ended life as a converted nunnery?
Okay. Oh, yes, you can see the cross above the door.
Yeah. Keep an open mind. It's something very different.
Very pretty.
We think we've got two really good options in the bag, so we've really mixed it up with the mystery house,
yeah.
Okay?
Yeah, why not?
Let's go.
Absolutely.
This Grade II listed former nunnery dates back to 1847 and still has its chapel within the grounds. The house itself has been beautifully renovated while still retaining a host of period features.
Let's start with one of the two reception rooms on this raised ground floor.
Very nice.
Yeah, it's really big, really big. Windows both sides as well, makes it incredibly
really
bright.
Yeah, it's really light. Mm-hmm. And it's a great size. I mean, it's enormous, really, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. And this house is slightly different in the way it's laid out, the fact that you've got this reception room here. You can just sneak a peek through there to more of a snug or a music room.
Still pretty big.
Yeah, and then downstairs, as we'll see, you've got the cooking area.
All right, OK.
Let's keep walking around. Okay. See if you can adapt to a very different kind of house. Mm-hmm. Come with me.
Heading out of the living room, we descend the main staircase to the lower ground floor.
So on the lower ground floor, we've got a really good-sized kitchen.
Yeah.
Yeah, really lovely kitchen. Downstairs, but actually really light and airy.
Good job on the conservatory here.
But big, isn't it?
Yeah,
it's
really
big.
Really well done.
Now, you've got a room next door. Okay, it serves at the moment as a spare bedroom, but I thought, you know, if you were to come downstairs to do your cooking, you'd either have that as a little TV room or just as a formal dining room, wouldn't you? But let's have a peek at one of the bedrooms, just so you see the dimensions of it, and then we'll go outside,
Come with me.
That concludes the living accommodation on the lower and ground floors. Up on the first floor, there are three double bedrooms, which all have their own particular style. They're served by a beautiful modern family bathroom. And we're making our way to the largest of the three bedrooms, complete with its own ensuite.
Well, the master bedroom has all the character.
Oh, yeah, lovely bedroom.
The developer was made to keep as much of this as possible. It's great to list it, this building is.
Okay, yes.
Look at it, it's beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah, they've made a great job.
Three bedrooms on this floor.
Right.
Okay. All right. Which means you might have to sacrifice the dining room, lower floor.
The one that got as a bedroom is the fourth.
Or your guests would sleep in their very own chapel.
Yes, I know.
Out here.
I've been
Come with me.
Wondering what is over there.
Despite there being a lot of accommodation on offer, Kat's suspicions are correct. There's even more to explore. As we head outside, I'm hoping the next self-contained portion of this house won't fail to impress.
Now, I distinctly remember you saying on your shopping list you wanted a chapel. Right?
Oh, my word. I'm going to say holy moly, but, well, I don't know what to say. Unbelievable.
That's incredible, isn't it?
Well, I won't have to go far on Sunday morning, will I?
I bet even you'd still be late for this.
Or is it party Saturday night and you get very irreverent?
yeah, plenty more likely. What would you use it for?
It'd be a games room, wouldn't it? And a party room, absolutely. Yeah, couldn't
definitely.
Be anything else.
Must take quite a lot to heat it, though.
You've got underfloor heating.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Thought of everything.
Which is handy. Yeah, it's handy, isn't it?
Yeah. It's stunning, and but for me, I was just saying to Chris, it's a little bit like city living in the countryside, isn't it? It's still not right.
Let's go outside so you can start having a bit of a guess toward the price.
The mystery twist to this proposition is the garden, as our couple will have to compromise on their initial vision. What we do have are lawned areas with raised borders, stocked with mature plants and shrubs. So has this extraordinary property done enough to win them over?
You can actually see the size of this property now.
It's
not small, is it?
It's not small at all.
Maybe not for you, but as an exercise into comparing it with the other properties, let's have a go at guessing the price.
£750.
Chris, have a go.
I'll say
£751,000.
And you know what? It serves you right because she's spot on at 750.
Oh, wow. Well done, Kat.
Well done, me.
Well done. It's a quirky property. It's been fabulous to walk around it. Yeah. I'm sure you'll agree. But
absolutely.
I think now's a good time for you to just have a scoot around this place on your own, and then I'll meet you at the front. How's that?
OK.
OK?
Great.
See you in a moment.
Thank you. Thank you.
At £750,000, this impressive Grade 2 listed house would offer the right person a wealth of features, with its great kitchen diner, four bedrooms, that extraordinary party room in what was once the chapel, and a central village location.
It has a lot of character, it has this amazing second building attached to it, which was something we were after, but at the same time, there's other downsides in that it doesn't have the extra land. And, you know, we can't really put our stamp on the property.
I mean, when you walk into that chapel, it's unbelievable. The mosaic features and the mosaics are beautiful. And you're sort of searching for the positives, which there are plenty, but just not for us. And deep down, I know that it's not our dream home.
Well, that's it, guys. No more houses.
I know, sad.
Well, also, time, though, for you to maybe sit down and have a chat. Yeah, maybe so. This will help make your mind up about the other two properties you saw yesterday.
Yeah.
Shall we go?
Yorkshire's stunning landscape has long been a magnet for tourists worldwide. Its near 1,500 miles of pathways are renowned with ramblers and walkers, many of them sporting a stick or cane. Canes became popular in the mid-1600s, and a middle-class gentleman would often have two. A rustic one for walks in the country, and a decorative cane to show off their wealth. Today, one man is keeping this legacy alive. Keith Pickering, affectionately known as the Stick Man, has spent over 30 years making canes at his North York Moors workshop, and I've come to see just what is involved.
Keith, are you the Stick Man?
That's me.
What a title. Lovely to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I would like to know how on earth you got into making these lovely sticks.
It started off as a hobby. My wife bought me this little fella.
Oh, right.
She bought that at a dog show, and I absolutely loved it. And I thought I'd have a go. Each time I made one, it actually got better than the previous ones. If you look at that, that was the old one 30 years ago, and this is the sort of thing I do nowadays.
Wow. Yeah, I mean, it's a transformation, isn't it? Look at that. The detail on it is amazing. This, the head, is it the same material? Is it the same piece of wood or...?
Not on that one. On the old original, yeah, that was a side branch growing off the one piece. But nowadays I do like this. That's another pheasant that I'm doing. So I start off with a blank piece of wood.
Yeah.
And I carve it roughly to shape and then I put the face on.
Keith produces a wide range of cane styles, from ornate to rustic. But they all start life in the same way. And to get that perfect finish, it's crucial to select the right piece of wood for the job.
So what would you normally be looking for the right kind of stick then, Keith?
On a hazel bush like this, we're looking for what you call the sun sticks, which are the ones that grow straight up and they're heading for the sun and come often from the bottom and they'll go straight up. We can get a nice 4-foot length out of that one. Once it's trimmed off, it'll look quite nice, and when it's dried, it'll make a good walking stick.
Because of its lightness and abundance, hazel is Keith's wood of choice when it comes to making canes. But as straight as they may look to you and I, in the world of walking sticks, they're not quite straight enough. Back at his workshop, though, Keith has a cunning plan to iron out those pesky curves. And he's letting me loose on one of his precious samples.
As you rotate it, you're looking for the biggest bend there.
I can see one here.
So turn that round until it's touching the table.
Yeah.
And then just get the piece of chalk and mark it there where it touches the table.
A small chalk mark pinpoints the section of wood that needs straightening.
Switch that on.
Next, a gentle bit of heat softens the wood fibres so they become pliable and easier to move.
Right, that should do.
And so, we want to bend it.
Chalk side away from you. Don't be frightened of it. And just leave it there.
It does look like it's bent double the other way, doesn't it?
Well, yeah, it's virtually gone the opposite from what it was. Off now.
So it says malleable for wild, doesn't it? But...
Oh, crikey.
Well, we've just gone a little bit too far, but it's so flexible now. Just watch.
Oh, wow.
If you fancy one of these sticks, you might have a bit of a wait. Keith and his wife Jackie have a packed order book from clients of all ages.
And I've got 42 sticks of my own to make, and Jackie's got a few of hers to do as well. So
goodness me.
I've got at least 6 months in front of me.
Keith might well have a few more orders to add to the list when our couple make the move to North Yorkshire. But it remains to be seen whether it will be into any of the houses we've shown them.
Well, it doesn't look like the gamble of the mystery house has paid off, but for my mind, there is still one clear favourite property. Time to find out from Chris and Kat what they want to do next. So, time to tell me your favourite property. Pretty sure I know which one it is, but put me out of my misery.
Number two!
It was, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, number two.
Yeah, absolutely.
For both of you, though, I know you were very emotional at the time.
Mm-hmm.
Chris?
Yeah, it was an outright winner, definitely.
You seemed pretty much on board from the get-go. Cat.
Yeah, I loved it from the outside, the setting. It was a beautiful property, mm-hmm. Lovely wisteria. And I think it's got features that you just can't find in, you know, in a more modern property.
Yep.
And that it's just got, yeah, timeless features that are really beautiful and made it just really nostalgic for me as well. It's a lovely property.
Let's talk about Tiergate. Why did it draw out such emotion in you then, Kat?
I don't know, it just, yeah, just had memories of my childhood, and even though it was a totally different property, there was just a few things that reminded me of my childhood. And I think, you know, when you have children, you sort of want to have elements of that again for your children, even though they maybe seem a little bit unrealistic. But I have had now the benefit of 24 hours, but I still really like it, and I think we'll try and get another viewing to get back
to it. You
were,
would you?
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
It wasn't just about the house. We had to find you the right location. Mm-hmm. And I think property number two did get that balance right, didn't it?
Yeah, certainly. We're moving out of London, where we've already got a community and lots of friends and family there.
Mm-hmm.
So we really need to put the children in somewhere straight away.
Yeah.
Where they can get friends from school and also in the local village. And yeah, that sports field with a cricket pitch right there, we can really see our children getting involved in this from an early stage.
But good luck, you know. You've had the emotional viewing.
Yeah.
You know, now's the time to sort of dot the I's and cross the T's.
Yeah, be a bit sensible about it. Well, thank you very much. It's been an experience. We've really enjoyed
absolutely.
It.
Absolutely, thank you
it's
so much.
It's been great fun showing you around the houses. I just wish you the best of luck.
Mm-hmm.
And hopefully, this is the first stage in this big move up here.
Yeah.
Good luck with it.
Thank you.
Well, it's not often we find a house that gives our buyers absolutely everything they said they're after. But house number two did exactly that, and I think Kat's emotional reactions to it says it all. But now, I suppose it's time to remove the emotion from the equation. Now is the time to go back with a slightly colder heart for that second viewing, but also to consider the family and the area as a whole. But I do hope they do that soon, because to me, well, that property suited them and their family right down to the ground. I wish them all the very best of luck.
Chris and Kat did go back for that second viewing and made an offer, which I'm happy to say was accepted. We wish them well with their new life in the beautiful county of North Yorkshire. If you would like to escape to the country in England, Northern Ireland, Wales or Scotland and need our help, you can apply online at bbc.co.uk/beontheshow.